हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू बैक माय यूट्यूब चैनल फॉर यू
भगवान पांडेकर
स्पीकिंग बिफोर यू एज ए मैथ्स टीचर एंड करियर काउंसलर टू टीच यू द सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स। सो एज वी ऑल नो द मैथमेटिक्स इट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स, दैट इज अल्जेब्रा एंड ज्योमेट्री। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द सेकेंड लेसन ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स पार्ट टू, ज्योमेट्री, दैट इज पैरेलल लाइन। इफ यू वुड लाइक टू दिस see many more videos like this, so please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel. Keep watching, keep learning, stay home, stay safe. Now I start the explanation of this lesson, the solving practice set 2.2. so without wasting any time, let us start this video. Lesson number 2, parallel lines, practice set 2.2. Example number first. In the figure, y is equal to 108 degree and x is equal to 71 degree. Are the lines m and n parallel? Justify. This is a given figure of this example. Solution: y is equal to 108 degree, x is equal to 71 degree. That is a given information. Therefore, x plus y is equal to 180 degree. Reason is property of the interior angles of parallel lines. Therefore, putting the values of x and y in the given equation, we can write 71 degree plus 108 degree is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, 179 degree is not equal to 180 degree. Therefore, x plus y is not equal to 180 degree. Therefore, line m is not parallel to the line n, as it does not satisfy the interior angle test for parallel lines. Example number 2. In the given figure, if angle A congruence angle B, then prove that line L parallel line m. This is the figure of this given examples. Solution: consider angle C as shown in the figure. Angle A congruence angle B, that is a given information, that is equation first. Angle A congruence angle C, vertically opposite angles, equation number 2. Angle B congruence angle C, from the equation first and second. Therefore, line L parallel line M, corresponding angle test for parallel lines. Example number 3. In the figure, if angle A congruence angle B and angle X congruence angle Y, prove that line L parallel line N. This is a given example's figure. Observing this figure, we can solve this example in this way. Solution: angle A and angle B are the corresponding angles formed by line L and N and the transversal K. Angle A congruence angle B is a given information. Therefore, line L parallel line N. Reason is corresponding angle test. This is equation first. Angle X and angle Y are the alternate angle formed by a line M and N and a transversal K. Angle X congruence angle Y, this is given information. Therefore, line M parallel line N. Reason is alternate angle test for parallel lines. This is equation number 2. From equation first and second, line M is a parallel to the line L and N. Therefore, line L parallel line N, this is your final answer and hence the proof. Example number 4. In the figure, if ray BA parallel ray D and angle C is equal to 50 degree and angle D is equal to 100 degree. Find the measures of angle ABC. Hint, draw a line passing through the point C and parallel to the line AB. This is a given figure of this example. Observing this figure, we can solve the example in this way. Solution. Draw a line XY passing through the point C and parallel to line AB. Ray D parallel ray BA. This is a given information. Ray BA parallel ray XY. Reason is construction. Ray D parallel ray BA. Parallel line XY. This is your equation number first. Angle EDC is equal to 100 degree. That is given information. Ray DE parallel line XY from equation first and line CD is a transversal. Therefore, angle EDC congruence angle DCX, reason is alternate angles. Therefore, angle EDC is equal to angle DCX. Angle DCX is equal to 100 degree. That is a given information. That is angle EDC is equal to 100 degree. Therefore, angle DCB plus angle BCX is equal to angle DCX. Reason is angles addition postulate. Therefore, 50 degree plus angle BCX is equal to 100 degree. Therefore, angle BCX is equal to 100 degree minus 50 degree. Therefore, angle BCX is equal to 50 degree. This is the equation. Therefore, ray BA parallel line XY from equation first and line BC is a transversal. Angle ABC plus angle BCX is equal to 180 degree. Reason is interior angle test. Therefore, angle ABC plus 50 degree is equal to 180 degree from equation 2. Therefore, angle ABC is equal to 180 degree minus 50 degree. Therefore, angle ABC is equal to 130 degree. Therefore, angle ABC is equal to 130 degree. This is your final answer. Example number 5. In the figure, ray AE parallel ray BD. Ray AF is a bisector of angle EAB and ray BC is a bisector of angle ABD. Prove that line AF parallel line BC. This is your given examples figure. Observing this figure and given information, we can solve this example in this way. Solution. Ray AE parallel ray BD. That is your given information. Line AB is a transversal. Angle EAB congruence angle ABD. Reason is alternate angle. Therefore, angle EAB equal to angle ABD. Multiplying both sides by 1/2, we get 1/2 into angle EAB is equal to 1/2 into angle ABD. This is your equation first. 1/2 into angle FAB is equal to 1/2 into angle EAB. Reason is ray AF bisect angle EAB. 1/2 into angle ABC is equal to 1/2 into angle ABD. This is your equation 2. Therefore, 1/2 into angle ABC is equal to 1/2 into angle ABD. Reason is ray BC bisect angle ABD. Therefore, angle FAB is equal to angle ABC from equation first, second and third. Therefore, angle FAB congruence angle ABC. Therefore, line AF parallel line BC. Reason is alternate angle test for the parallel lines. Example number 6. A transversal EF of line AB and line CD intersect the line at point P and Q respectively. Ray PR and ray QS are parallels and bisector of angle BPQ and angle PQC respectively. Prove that line AB parallel line CD. This is a figure of this example. Observing this figure, we can solve this example in this way. Solution. Ray PR parallel ray QS. That is a given information. And line PQ is a transversal. Therefore, angle RPQ congruence angle PQS. Reason is alternate angles. Therefore, angle RPQ is equal to angle PQS. This is your first equation. Therefore, angle RPQ is equal to 1/2 angle BPQ. Reason is ray PR bisect angle BPQ. That is equation number 2. Therefore, angle PQS is equal to 1/2 into angle PQC. Reason is ray QS bisect angle PQC. That is your equation 3rd. Therefore, from equation 1st, 2nd and 3rd, we can write 1/2 into angle BPQ is equal to 1/2 angle PQC from equation 1st, 2nd and 3rd. Therefore, angle BPQ is equal to angle PQC. Therefore, angle BPQ congruence angle PQC. Therefore, line AB parallel line CD. Reason is alternate angle test for the parallel lines. Thanks for watching this video, my dear friends. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel, that is Bhagwan Pandekar Maths for You, and my second channel is Bhagwan Pandekar Career Counselor. If you see many more videos like this, so please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel. Keep watching, keep learning, stay home, stay safe. Thank you so much.